Elon Musk just confirmed SpaceX's first orbital Starship launch. According to CEO Elon Musk, SpaceX will likely be prepared to undertake its maiden orbital Starship launch in November 2022, potentially as early as late October. However, there are still a lot of significant obstacles. In response to a discussion regarding a recent test of the engines on Booster 7, Musk posted the update on Twitter. By that time, Musk predicted, "We will have two boosters and spacecraft ready for orbital flight, with full stack manufacturing at roughly one per 2 months," on Twitter. Hello everyone, welcome back to Elon Musk Evolution, where we bring you the most recent news about Elon Musk and his multi-billion-dollar companies. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss out on any of our amazing videos. The SpaceX system, which consists of the Starship, Spaceship, and the Super Heavy booster, is a fully reusable, extremely super heavy lift launch vehicle intended to travel to Earth orbit, the Moon, and maybe even beyond, to planets like Mars. As part of the space agency's Artemis 3 mission, SpaceX is required by a contract with NASA to demonstrate that Starship can land people on the Moon by late 2025. Musk took to Twitter on September 21st to add to a much-appreciated burst of information about SpaceX's Starship rocket development and to give some more precise information. After an unexpectedly successful and record-breaking static fire test on September 18th, the CEO of SpaceX announced on September 19th that the Starship booster B7, currently tasked with that debut, would be rolled back to the factory for unexplained robustness upgrades. This announcement came just hours before the scheduled launch date. The thrust component of Super Heavy Booster 7 may need to be strengthened to make it more resilient to Raptor engine failures, according to Musk's latest statement made 2 days later. Even though the answer deviates slightly from SpaceX's usual course, the concern is understandable given that it is powered by 33 Raptor V2 engines and that there is ample evidence that these engines are far from being 100% reliable. Before starting the procedures for Starship's first orbital launch, SpaceX rushed through the creation of the rocket as if it wanted to obliterate as many other rockets as it could, which it sort of did. SpaceX produced Starships and test articles on a regular basis and vigorously tested them, as opposed to spending 6 to 12 months working on the same few prototypes without really ever trying to launch them. While there were a few instances where SpaceX pushed a bit too far and made mistakes that should have been avoided, the majority of the failures generated a lot of data that was subsequently used to enhance subsequent vehicles. The high-altitude Starship flight testing phase of the project, which saw SpaceX complete test and launch a new Starship 5 times in 6 months, was the project's pinnacle. In May 2021, the first totally successful high-altitude Starship launch and landing took place. The preparation for SpaceX's orbital flight test have been so drastically different. Although there's been substantial advancement in the 16 months since SN15's safe launch and touchdown, it's obvious that SpaceX has chosen to avoid taking major risks. Super Heavy Booster 4 and Starship 20, the first orbital class pair, were completed and tested over the course of more than 6 months, but SpaceX never even conducted a single static burn on Booster 4 and promptly retired both prototypes without even trying to launch either. We may never know why SpaceX shut down B4 and S20, or why the company appears to have changed its development strategy to be a little more cautious after blatantly proving the effectiveness of moving quickly and taking significant risks. This is because Musk and SpaceX have not provided any information. It's likely that receiving a $3 billion contract that puts Starship at the forefront of NASA's mission to send astronauts back to the Moon has prompted a more cautious approach. In April 2021, SpaceX was awarded that contract. And even in its third and more conservative phase, Starship development is still incredibly hardware intensive, moving swiftly and discovering many issues on the ground instead of learning from flight tests. But that doesn't change the fact that the third phase of Starship development, which began in H2 2021 and is currently underway, is moving along with more caution than the first and second phases, which took place in Q4 2018 to Q4 2019 and Q1 2020 to Q2 2021, respectively. However, it seems as though SpaceX is finally coming closer to launching Starship into space. Musk believes that SpaceX will have two pairs of orbital-class Starships and Super Heavy boosters, BS-S24 and B8-S25, ready for orbital flight by then, potentially enabling a quick return to flight after the first attempt. He claims that the company could be prepared for the first launch attempt as early as late October, but a November attempt is highly likely. Musk is especially enthusiastic about a Super Heavy Booster 9, which has several several design modifications and a thrust section that will completely isolate each of the 33 Raptors from one another, which is essential for preventing the failure of one engine from affecting others. Super Heavy Booster 8 arrived at the launch pad on September 19th, as predicted by Musk, and will probably undergo a proof testing soon, while Booster 7 is being improved back at the factory. Even though that is encouraging, history has proven that reality may often diverge significantly from Elon Musk's descriptions, especially when it comes to Starship's orbital launch debut. For instance, Musk stated that SpaceX would launch its first Super Heavy static fire from Starbase's orbital launch pad later that month. This prediction was made in September 2021. The actual date of the key test was August 9, 2022, 11 months later, and a completely different booster was used. This means that even if tremendous progress has been achieved over the past several months, SpaceX still has a lot of work to do, practically all of which is in unexplored territory. Starship 24, which earlier this month completed its maiden 6-engine static fire, is presently undergoing odd adjustments that appear to indicate that the upper stage is not meeting SpaceX's expectations. It's unclear if more testing will be necessary. After a successful 7 Raptor static fire, Super Heavy B7's returning to the plant for more development. SpaceX will need to execute the first full Super Heavy wet dress rehearsal, completely fueling the booster with thousands of tons of combustible propellant, and the first full 33 Raptor static burn after it returns to the pad, while the exact sequence is unknown. It's unclear if SpaceX will stick with its cautious strategy, testing 1, 3, and 7 engines over the course of 6 weeks, or move right on to 33-engine testing. Furthermore, it's not clear how Ship 24 fits into that picture. In order to properly test the rocket under the conditions it would launch under, SpaceX will eventually need to, or should, perform a full wet dress rehearsal of the fully stacked Starship, and may even try a 33-engine static fire with the fully fueled two-stage vehicle. Will SpaceX fully stack B7 and S24 as soon as the booster reaches the launch pad, risking a Starship that could be fit for flight while conducting the most dangerous Super Heavy test to date? The company will exercise prudence and perform 33-engine static burns before and after stacking, wet dress rehearsals before and after, increasing the amount of testing that may be necessary, as evidenced by SpaceX's most recent year of operations. All Booster 7 activity to date implies that SpaceX will choose to progressively build up to 33 engines, so one or more additional tests will also be necessary if that's the course of action chosen. Having a fully loaded Starship ready to launch by the end of November will be a significant task for SpaceX in either case. Musk's estimated time frame is likely to be unattainable if any substantial issues are encountered during any of the several unheard-of tests mentioned above. The FAA has yet to provide SpaceX a license or experimental authorization for orbital Starship flights, both of which are dependent upon a plethora of mitigation, so that is a potential hazard. This is not to imply that a Starship launch attempt into orbit couldn't happen in November, but it seems more unlikely that SpaceX will be able to launch the duo before the end of 2022, especially in light of the numerous problems Booster 7 and Ship 24 have had during relatively simpler tests. And that ends today's episode. We hope you enjoyed our video. Please subscribe and leave a comment down below your own thoughts, and don't forget to like today's video. We'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.